In today's video, I'll be sharing 10 interesting facts about the beautiful country of Kuwait, an Arab kingdom in Asia on the northwestern coast of the Persian Gulf, or the Arabian Gulf if you live in Kuwait. Welcome back to FTD Facts. I'm Sarah Carvalho and I'm excited to be here with another informative video for you all. Today's video is near and dear to my heart as it brings us to explore the country of Kuwait, my home for the last 5 years, and a country with many aesthetic sights to experience. So let's get started with the facts. So starting with number 10, the name Kuwait actually means fort. Kuwait is derived from an Arabic word, aqwat, which means fortress built near water. Until the 18th century, Kuwait hardly had any settlements, but the area was visited by nomads who would come and go. However, when drought struck the desert area, they built fortified settlements near the coast of the Gulf in what is known today as Kuwait. Moving on to talking about the currency. The Kuwaiti dinar is the official currency of Kuwait. Interestingly, it is subdivided into 1,000 fils. So 1,000 fils would be one Kuwaiti dinar. To compare that with Canadian money, 100 cents would equal one Canadian dollar. The Kuwaiti dinar was introduced in 1961 to replace the Gulf rupee. At first, it was equivalent to the British pound sterling, but today it is currently the highest currency in the world when measured against the US dollar. So one Kuwaiti dinar equals $4.29 Canadian, $3.26 US, and €2.78. The high value rate of its currency is explained by significant oil exports into the global market. Due to the stable petroleum-based economy, highly developed oil production and export, Kuwait is considered to be one of the richest countries in the world. Now that brings us to talk about the oil industry, which is a huge part of Kuwait. Kuwait is actually a major oil supplier. Oil comprises nearly half of Kuwait's GDP, around 95% of exports, and approximately 90% of the government revenue. Kuwait holds approximately 7% of the global oil reserves and has a current production capacity of about 3.15 million barrels per day. The Kuwait Petroleum Corporation, or KPC, has announced its intention to increase oil production capacity to 4 million barrels per day by 2020. Moving on to talk a little bit about culture. So the Sheikh Jaber Al Ahmed Cultural Center, or the JACC, known by most, is informally known as the Kuwait Opera House, and it is a prominent cultural center in Kuwait. Interestingly, it is the largest cultural center and opera house in the Middle East. The center strives to entertain, educate, and inspire the people of Kuwait, offering a range of events in music, theater, films, workshops, and spoken word. Now, the cultural center complex is divided into many different buildings, which include theaters, concert halls, music centers, libraries, a public park, many restaurants, and a large interactive water fountain. The cultural center took 2 years to complete and a budget of $775 million. Moving on to fact number six, the world's fourth longest sea bridge is in Kuwait. The Sheikh Jaber Al Ahmed Al Sabah Causeway is a mega bridge project with an estimated construction value of approximately 3.6 billion US dollars that spans the Bay of Kuwait in two directions and comprises of two links. The main link, which connects Kuwait City with the future Silk City, and the Doha link, which connects Kuwait City with Doha and the Kuwait Entertainment City. So this project actually forms part of the Kuwait National Development Plan for 2035. The bridges are named after the late Sheikh Jaber Al Sabah, who reigned during the Gulf War to commemorate his contribution to the development of Kuwait. It is one of the largest and most challenging transport infrastructure projects in Kuwait, as well as the entire Middle East region. The main link is the fourth longest road bridge in the world at 36.14 kilometers. Both bridges have a combined length of 48.5 kilometers. It leads from the capital, Kuwait City's free trade zone, to an uninhabited area set to become another thriving port, Silk City. Bringing us to fact number five, where we're actually going to talk about this Silk City. The Medina Al-Harir, Arabic for Silk City, is a proposed 250 kilometer squared urban area in the Subia region of northeastern Kuwait. So apart from a free trade zone and seaport, the Silk City will have an airport, an Olympic stadium, a tower taller than Dubai's Burj Khalifa, and housing for up to 700,000 people. Now, the cost of this long-term mega development is estimated to be more than $100 billion. $1 billion, hence the causeway's strategic importance to the country. Now, interestingly, much of the free trade zone development will be done in partnership with China after the two countries signed memorandums in the past several years. The vision is for the causeway to establish Kuwait as an international trading center connecting the Middle East with the rest of Asia. Next, we're going to talk about shopping. Now, Kuwait is home to the Avenues Mall, Kuwait. The Avenues Mall is the largest shopping mall in the country. The mall opened its doors in April 2007 under the patronage of Sheikh Sabah Al Ahmed Al Sabah. It was the winner of the ICSC Gold Award for Best Shopping Center of 2013 under the expansion and design category in the Middle East and North Africa. Since it first opened in 2007, the Avenues has continuously developed and enhanced the shopping experience in Kuwait to outstanding levels. It has set new benchmarks and standards throughout the industry. It is considered to be one of the largest malls in the world with more than 1,100 stores spread over 12 districts. The districts are inspired by classical and modern architecture. They include the First Avenue, Second Avenue, Prestige, Grand Avenue, Souk, the Mall, Soku, the Arcades, Grand Plaza, Electra, the Forum, and the Garden, and parking spaces that fit more than 10,000 cars. You guys, I've been there. It's an amazing sight to see. Any store you could think of is pretty much in this shopping center, and restaurant as well. All right, moving on to fact number three, no income tax. Yes, Kuwait is among 15 countries around the world who do not have income taxes. How is this possible? Well, Kuwait is a small, wealthy country that earned its fortune through the oil industry, so it doesn't need to levy an income tax, making it a very attractive living and working destination for expatriates. Speaking of expatriates, that's going to bring us to talking about the population of Kuwait. The current population of Kuwait is 4,288,398 as of Wednesday, October 14, 2020, based on Worldometer elaboration of the latest United Nations data. Now, shockingly, two-thirds of the population are non-nationals. Expatriates account for about 70% of Kuwait's population, including 1.1 million Arab expatriates and 1.4 million Asian expatriates. The Kuwait government rarely grants citizenship to foreigners to maintain its status quo. Now, Kuwait actually recognizes itself as a very expat-friendly country as it is highly Americanized, especially in the hub of Kuwait City. Now, as I mentioned a little bit earlier, obtaining permanent residency in Kuwait generally requires you to have either Kuwaiti relatives or formal employment within the country. Kuwait also doesn't have much need for foreign investment, so citizenship by investment is also not a possibility. And actually, all businesses in Kuwait must be officially owned by Kuwaiti nationals. All right, moving on to our last fact of today. Number one brings us to talk about the beautiful Kuwait Towers. So in the Shark District of downtown Kuwait City lies one of the country's most visually arresting landmarks, the Kuwait Towers. With its panoramic views and striking modern design, this group of symbolic towers has won iconic architectural status globally. They have become a symbol of the nation's prosperity and urbanization, known to the locals as Al Abraj, translated simply to the towers. The monument's prominent location is on the Arabian Gulf Sea front, which adds to popularity among tourists and locals alike. Now, the core inspiration for the tower's design came from a balance between the modernity and tradition, with the rocket and globe form representing the intertwined nature of two fundamental ideals, humanity and technology. The main tower rises to 185 meters and is one where you will be headed when visiting the towers. It has two spheres, one of which is called the viewing sphere. It has a revolving viewing platform at a height of 120 meters and offers sweeping views of the surrounding area. The tower also houses a selection of restaurants which are very popular among locals. The middle tower is true to its original function and still is used as a water tower. And the smaller tower, which is designed simply for aesthetic reasons, is used as a source of electricity and illuminates the other two towers. For those seeking a unique gastronomic experience, the 90-seater restaurant located within the tower sphere is a fun place to dine. For another awesome experience, be sure to check out the towers at night as they light up with various designs. That was 10 facts about Kuwait. I hope you enjoyed today's video. I know that for for me, it was definitely bittersweet being able to share my home for the last 5 years with you. Kuwait is a wonderful nation full of culture, beauty, and history, and I can only hope to be able to go back and visit in the future. And as always, we want to know what you think, so please leave your comments, suggestions, thoughts down below. If you enjoyed this video, I have another similar video that you have got to check out, so click on that link down there. No, actually, click it. All right, friends, that's all for today, but be sure to check back with FTD Facts for our daily videos, keeping you connected with this amazing and diverse world we call home. Bye.